Hi, it's Paris from EpicReviewsTech channel, and it was about 3 weeks ago that I got my Yoga 2 Pro. I am loving this computer. It is almost perfect. The one flaw is the Wi-Fi. It's wireless and sort of a spotty N at that. But I had read that for $30, you can pick up the little wireless card to put into this that will give you wireless AC, great range, strong connection. All you have to do is be willing to open this up. Now this is the Wi-Fi card that you need to get for the wireless AC upgrade. The BIOS in the Yoga 2 Pro is very picky and it won't take just any card. So make sure this is the one that you get. I'll put a link to it down below this video so you can see the exact model. Once you have your Wi-Fi card, you need a 5mm torx screwdriver. There are 11 screws on the bottom of the Yoga 2 Pro you'll need to remove. You need to have a device to do a little prying to get that cover to pop off. And then I'll show you inside the cables you need to disconnect, what you need to pull out, plug this in, put it all back together, and see if it really works. And before opening the system up, or even opening the package with the new network card, make sure you're not carrying a static charge. Touch some large metal object to drain that static electricity out so you don't give an electric shock to anything, any of the circuitry in here or in the new network card. Now you need a T5 torx screwdriver head, and this is smaller than what comes in most kits, so if you don't have that, here's the cheapest way I found to pick this up. This Pick Quick Teeny Turner is $5. You can pick it up at Fry's. If you're not near one, I'll put a link to it down below. You can order it online. It comes with a number of bit heads and it seems to be well made, but mainly it gives you that T5 that you're going to need to take off these screws. These guys are tiny and easy to lose. It's helpful that this comes with a magnetic tip. Down to the last screw, just wanted to mention here that you may be voiding your warranty doing this, so do that at your own risk. Also, before opening up any electronic device, you want to remove power, so of course unplug it from the wall, shut it down. Ordinarily on a laptop, you'd also pop the battery out, but in this case it's an internal battery, so we'll have to deal with that when we get to it. Okay, all the screws are out. Now it's supposed to be a matter of flexing it and popping this back cover off. Get a thumbnail under there. Poking around and pulling on the edges, I found that if you start here where the hinges are, get a fingernail underneath and pull, it feels like it'll come off pretty easily. There we go. Now we're inside. Here we've got the battery. You can see that takes up most of the innards of this system. A couple exhaust fans. The RAM that's soldered in place, so no memory upgrades. Over here is the solid state drive, and I believe that's a standard connector, but again, I don't know with the BIOS how picky it's going to be if you put a different brand of solid state drive in. And our target for today is right here. There's the Wi-Fi card. Now I'm going to unplug the battery before going on, that way that I can be sure there won't be any electricity running through here and I won't short circuit anything. Unplugging the battery is a matter of pulling the cable out from the connector right here. It's tiny, my fingers are fat. May need another instrument for this. Requires a great deal of pulling to get it out. All right. It's defused. Now the manual for the Yoga 2 Pro says after taking off the back cover, you need to remove the battery pack, the LCD unit, and the system board before removing the Wi-Fi card, but I'm going to see if I can't just jump ahead and do it. It looks like everything I need is right here, so let's see if we can't just unscrew this, remove the antenna leads, and pull it out. So we've got two, what they call wireless LAN cables, I assume they're the antenna leads, black and white right here, one screw, some tape holding it down on both sides, and then here at this end is where it actually slides into the slot and little metal contacts take place. And they tell you to start by removing the black and white cables. I'm thinking it's just a matter of pulling them straight back. Again, everything is super tiny and miniature though. It's actually more like a snap. Yeah, kind of like on a 9-volt battery, the little cap that snaps over the top. So that's different. I did not expect that. So it's just a matter of pulling it up gently and then the cover will pop off the top of it. Okay, the question is how easily will it go back on? With those cables pulled back out of the way, at this point you need a very small Phillips head screwdriver, not a Torx. Right there. And we've got the tape. I guess you either have to pry it up or just slice it along each edge to let the card come out. Tape is loose. I should now be able to gently lift it a little and pull it out of that slot. Okay, yeah, it's got to come up over the screw hole and then pull back gently. There's the old wireless card. Now it's a matter of reversing everything. So I've got the wireless card. The first thing is to slide it most of the way to flat and then push it down as it goes past this screw hole and it slides and makes contact. It is in place. Next is the tiny Phillips head screw. Now we need to reattach the antennas. This is the tricky part. But it does say in the manual that the black cable goes to the little connector labeled main and the white cable goes to aux. And in very tiny print on the white label here on the Wi-Fi card, right next to this little button, it says main and the one here on the end says aux. I'm going to try to fit this over the little button and see if I can push it on by hand or if I need a tool. Finally, I got my snap. Okay, white one is on. Snap number two. All right. I think we're reassembled. Don't forget to plug the battery back in. At this point, you cross your fingers, put the cover back on. Now there are snaps along each edge, so they'll have to re-engage. If you've had much practice taking the cover off the back of your cell phone, it kind of feels the same. Back to the Torx screwdriver, and so glad that it's magnetized. Here's the last screw. Okay, question number one, does it still turn on? I've got lights and no smoke yet. And here you can see under network adapters, Intel dual band wireless AC7260. And here's my current Wi-Fi status on my 5 gigahertz AC network. What I'm seeing is it's obviously found the new card and installed the driver. It's showing me my local networks, plus a new one that I didn't see before, Guadalupe Peak, my 5 gigahertz network, which means the new card is working. Looks fine. Everything else on the computer still seems to work, so I'm guessing I didn't break anything. I'll give the new network card a workout over the next few days, see how the range is and the top speed, and if after a while it tends to drop connection like the old card did. I'm hoping that this is going to resolve all those issues and it was a successful transplant, but if it disappoints at all, I'll post another video and let you know.